Hello friends, welcome to the channel. Today we will discuss how to use while loop in LabVIEW program. Okay, so let's start. So this is the block diagram and this is the front panel, and in the front block diagram, if after right click you can see the structure, then in the structure you can see the while loop. Okay, click this and drag, like as I drag it earlier as well, like for loop case as well. So this is the while loop, and instead of in for loop there is one stop button, or is the condition button. So like when this condition will fulfill, that time this while loop will stop, and this I as same as earlier, this is the loop iteration, it will start from zero. Okay, now let's write one simple program using LabVIEW, okay, using while loop. Okay, so if you right click it, and you can see some numeric, boolean, structure, everything. So in the numeric you can select some divide, okay, and okay, let's choose I as one input in the divide option, and create this option as constant, and let's put it 500. Okay now you have to put one condition for the loop. So this is a loop condition. If you right click it, and you can see some create constant, control or indicator. You can create only control or constant. Let's say you want to create one this control. Okay, so now this top option will come here, and if you want to see the output, you have to create one indicator here. So create one indicator. Okay, so this is the indicator, that means it will show the output. And now let's run the program. Let's see what will happen. Okay, see, this is changing. It will change till when this loop condition will satisfy. That means if you press stop button, it will stop the loop. Okay, so now I will stop the loop. Okay, it will stop. Okay, so if you want to see in highlight option mode, then you can press this highlight option, then you can see slowly. So let's run the program. Okay, now this 500 by 0, that means infinity, then 500 divided by 1, then 2, then 3, it will continue till the when someone will press stop button. Okay, so now I will press the stop button, then it will stop. Okay, it stop. Okay, so and earlier as I told in for loop case also, if you put this output outside the loop, then you can only see the last result. That means if you press the stop button, and then this loop will stop, and at the last iteration, the result, that result will pass only through this wire. Okay, and then you can see the final result. Okay, so that you can do. And okay, one more thing, this is a very interesting loop, while loop. So if you want to do some RT measurement or something in some experiment, then this is a very useful loop. Okay, so that we will discuss in later section in a more different program. So for today, let's stop.